So my name is Layne Martin. Actually a real honor to be able to speak today. Like Eric, this yesterday was my first time ever on stage and speaking, so I really appreciate it. So imagine getting attacked by five of the most lethal people you've ever seen. I had that experience. I chose that experience and I embraced it. 3 years ago, I was initiated into one of the most elite martial arts groups around. I'll never forget that day. November, blue skies. The test started at 7 p.m. and went to 6 a.m. the next morning. 11 hours straight of getting the shit kicked out of you. No water, no food. Just pure will and mental toughness. You know, I walked into my apartment building at 7 a.m. I had a black eye on one eye, a cut on the other. The doorman in my building said, "Doc, are you okay?" I said, "Bobby, never better." I had a smile ear to ear. Why'd I do it? I dared to be great. And all of you could dare to be great without doing any crazy martial arts initiation. You know, that day in November was one of my best days, a day I'll never forget. One of my worst days, getting the call that my patient and my buddy, who was 40, died of sleep apnea. You've all heard the statistics. 40% of the population snore. 90 million Americans have sleep apnea. On that day, the statistics didn't matter. Only one did, my buddy. Everyone here has patients out there like that, with all the signs and symptoms of sleep apnea. I miss them, and I never want to miss them again. You know, there's a great book by Brené Brown, Daring Greatly, right? It talks about vulnerability and fear. For so long, I was afraid of being wrong. I was afraid of making mistakes. I did what I was comfortable doing, prepping teeth. And let me tell you, I was great at prepping teeth. I took so much pride in my preps, my restorations, achieving the ideal occlusion, but I missed the bigger problem, airway. You know, you've heard so many people talk about it, but you know, we have such an amazing opportunity to really bridge the gap between medicine and dentistry. You know, the fact is I haven't gotten a paycheck in 2 years, and this is the happiest I've been since I was in the military. I love waking up every day with a purpose. You know, I got comfortable doing what I was doing, and I had a great practice in Manhattan, New York, and it was lucrative, but I didn't love waking up every day. I felt like a mechanic. I wanted better. You know, I really, really embraced this whole airway sleep thing. You know, before I finish, I want to go back to my martial arts experience. I've run marathons. I've done triathlons. I went through boot camp in the military. I played competitive sports. Joining that elite martial arts brotherhood was the hardest thing I ever did. You know, people ask me, why'd you do it? I wanted to be better. We should all want to be better. You know, my friends ask me now, like, why do you go back? Why do you go sell your practice and go back to school? I wanted to be better. Again, we should all want to be better. You know, prior to selling my practice, I listened to a great TED talk by Sean Aker. He talked about happiness. And he defined happiness as the joy one feels striving towards their potential. You know what? Like, I'm striving towards my potential now, and it's great. There's a great quote by Bruce Lee, who's one of my idols. Don't pray for an easy life. Pray for the strength to endure a difficult one. I want to say to all of you, dare to be great. And if we dare to be great as a profession and dare to pivot and really focus on airway first, we could have the greatest impact on all of our patients. Thank you.